So, good morning, everybody. Thank you for joining me. So, my name is Bajan Ansar. I'm going to present you some results of my PhD, which is called Mechanical Behavior and Function Analysis of Dicey for Video and Determined by Basic Mining. So, this study is supported by the CTA. So, firstly, I'm going to make a quick introduction about laser beam welding. Then I will explain to you the microstructure evolution induced by this process. And the third part, I will present you the mechanical behavior and structure analysis of the work drain and the phase metal. And to finish, the conclusion and the further works of the PhD. So, laser beam welding allows to assemble mechanical components. So the principle is to convert light energy into thermal energy. So when the laser beam reaches the top surface of the joint, the temperature increases up to the polarization point. So you have here a numerical calculation made by U for one square plus. So when the temperature reaches the polarization point, the injective pressure induces a recoil pressure and it deforms the liquid solid interface and it creates a cavity. This cavity is called the keyhole. So at the end of the pulse, the power drops and the keyhole collapses. That's here. And after the solidification, it results in the voltage. So for one pulse, it's extremely fast. It needs approximately 50 milliseconds. So it induces high cooling rate. And in this titanium alloy, it induces Martensitic phase transformation, beta alpha prime. So you have in white here the fusion zone. This zone presents a Martensitic microstructure, which is called acicular. It consists of prior beta grain here, and which is fully of thin needles, alpha prime. So close to this zone, around here, you have the heat affected zone. This zone is a three-phase microstructure with thin needles alpha prime here in black. And the primary module in gray surrounded by a thin layer of beta phase. And far away from this structure, you have the base metal. So as I explained, the base metal is a titanium alloy. Here, the Ti6L4B. Here is the chemical composition of the material. So as we see, it presents an aqueous microstructure with primary module alpha P here in white, surrounded by a layer of beta phase. With X-ray diffraction, we estimate the mass fraction of alpha phase and beta phase. So here it appears that alpha phase represents 90% of the mass ratio. And we also performed with the same technique figure pole texture in order to determine the texture of the round bar. So it appears that the preferential direction given in this figure. So for this study, we used different type of specimens. So specimens were machined from thin plates. The plates were welded by laser beam welding. So we used a longitudinal tensor test and perpendicular tensor test. And in order to compare the mechanical and fracture behavior of the welded joint, we also machined base metal specimens. All specimens were machined in the parallel to the axis of the bar. So when we performed a tensile test, on World Journal and Lesbian Soul, it appears that the World Journal has a higher mechanical propriety than the Lesbian Soul, approximately 20%. This gap is also observed in microRNA's profile. In the fusion zone, the microRNA value is higher than in the Lesbian Soul. In this case, we talk about mismatch effect, and in particular, overmatch effect between the fusion zone and the base metal. We also observed this effect on transversal test spacements. We performed digital image correlation on the surface of the sample, and it appears that the strain localized in the base metal. So, all tests performed in this configuration, the fracture always occur in the base metal. And we also performed a tensile test in wallet structure. That means at the bottom of the wallet joint, it still remains a notch. This notch was machined in the previous spacement. So, could you, it's a video, could you click on
could you please?
We filmed the latest test.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you. We filmed this test with a high-speed camera at 360,000 frames per second in order to study the crack path of the behaviors. And when the crack propagates, the main cracks bifurcate in the base metal. And we also calculated the crack propagation rate, and we estimated at 9 meters per second. So, in order to understand more precisely the fracture of the welded joint, we studied the damage mechanism of the base metal and in the fusion zone. So, in the base metal, we identified the nucleation cavity. So, we find that cavity nucleated at the interface, for example here, at alpha. To two primary nodule alpha interface and boundary, and also in the intra alpha phase. But for this specific case, it is not really clear that the role of the beta phase in the nucleation mechanism. So we are currently performing the test in order to understand the role of the beta phase. In the fusion zone, because of the microstructure is completely different, the cavity initiation, cavity nucleation changes completely, and we identify that the cracks or cavity nucleate at the alpha prime interfaces, or sometimes in the great boundaries interfaces, but it's not clear the role of the beta phase, and we've just performed this kind of test, and with this analyze, we hope to understand correctly the role of the beta grain, of the primary beta grain. So, when we analyze the fracture surfaces, and when we compare this surface fracture with the damage mechanism, we found a similar result. That means in the base metal, we observed ductile damage with voids. Instead, on the other hand, on the fusion zone, we observed decohesion along alpha prime interfaces. And this is the fracture analysis of the wall structure. We observed two zones. The first at the bottom of the spacement, it appears that we can see pores. So these pores are induced by the welding process. If you want, I can explain you the formation of this pore after my presentation. And after the bifurcation here, we found the ductile simulate this kind of process would be to use a micro-mechanical approach with a Gerson-Zwigan-Edelman model. So the stochastic potential is given here. And this is the damage evolution that we choose. And we identify this, this equation with Institute homography test made by the French engineering school in Sarion with the same base metal. So we can see that that this model can describe correctly the damage mechanism. So we want to do the same for the fusion zone. So to set up, we observe that the microstructure induces a strong influence on mechanical behavior and in damage mechanism. So the first assessment of the model can correctly describe the kinematic damage of the base metal. We want to do the same for the base metal. Experimentally, we want to understand the role of the beta phase for the base metal and the role of the prior beta grain in the fusion zone. And we want, by internal simulation, we want to reproduce the walling structure when the fracture bifurcates into the base metal. So thank you for your attention.